thought she sends the whole thing. I'm like,
it covers up the entire Bible.
That's
pretty. That's why we had to, I had to take the break again.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-loving God, be with us this day. Let our melodies rise to you in praise. Let our lives be in harmony with each other. Help us to pray as well as sing to your word. And lead us this day to be the people of this kind of life and praise to you. Let us leave this place in peace.
The Lord be with you. Our gospel text today is Luke's version of the Lord's Prayer. So our theme will be prayer and persistence in prayer. So that's what that's all about. Our couple of announcements, one of which is there's a sign-up sheet for a potluck dinner next Sunday after this worship service. So sign up and we'll all share a meal together. There is also, if you read your messenger, an opportunity if you wanted to still go to Lutheran night at the ball game, you can still sign up. You don't get as much stuff, but for $9 you get a ticket and a ball cap, which I think is pretty good. I think if you read your bulletin, you'll see everything else. One thing I hadn't been announcing is that Linda Mikolajson, the director of our child care center, is leaving. She has she's leaving to take care of her sister who needs care. And Linda has been very good for us, and for Messiah Lighthouse has really turned that program around. There is a reception for her Tuesday night from 4 to 6, so if you cared to stop in and thank Linda, you could do that at that time. I don't think I have anything else to announce.
Let us pray. Lord, teach us to pray. Teach us to pray that we may pray without ceasing, and knowing that as we pray, that which we ask will be answered. That which we seek, we will find. And that when we knock upon your door, it will always be opened. Teach us to pray. Teach us to pray, Lord. In the name of the blessed, holy, glorious Trinity, one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Please rise and join in singing.
Right.
to sing together as we profess our faith. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Almighty and merciful God, you established your church with the power of the Holy Spirit. Fill us with that sacred fire that we may ignite with a passion for your will. Inflame our hearts to do good works in the building of your church. Finally, burn down the walls that keep us from you. These things we ask in your name.
Existentially, there's something about us that we realize that we live in a broken world and we are broken people. Now, to broken people, God is faithful to us and says to us that for the sake of Jesus Christ, God forgives you and me, all our sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lesson today comes from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 11th chapter. Jesus was praying in a certain place, and after he had finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins. For we ourselves forgive everyone indebted to us, and do not bring us to the time of trial.'" And he said to them, "Suppose one of you has a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say to him, 'Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread, for a friend of mine has arrived, and I have nothing to set before him.' And he answers from within, 'Do not bother me. The door has already been locked, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot get up and give you anything.' I tell you, even though he will not get up and give him anything because he is his friend, at least because of his persistence, he will get up and give him whatever he needs. So I say to you, ask and it will be given you. Search and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened for you. For everyone who asks receives. And everyone who searches finds. And for everyone who knocks, the door will be opened. Is there anyone among you who, if your child asks for a fish, will give a snake instead of a fish? Or if the child asks for an egg, will give a scorpion? If you then, who are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will the Heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask him?" The Gospel of the Lord. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Share God's peace by greeting those around you. I'd like to invite the children to come on up. Good morning. We are going to talk about prayer for a minute. Did you know I have a grandson? And he started at, when he was a baby, at our child care center. And believe it or not, they thought it was important to teach them how to pray, at least teach them how, what posture to have when we pray. Jesus' disciples, by the way, said, "Jesus, teach us how to pray." They saw Jesus going to pray quite a bit and said, "Jesus, teach us how to pray." Anyway, here's what they taught my grandson when they, before they say table grace, a little rhyme. Open, shut them, open, shut them, give a little clap. Open, shut them, fold them just like that. How many of you heard that before? Well, very good. Some of you have. Some of you have been in our child care center. Okay. Now, that's not teaching us how to pray, but it's giving us a position. We do that. We've learned to fold our hands. Why do we fold our hands and close our eyes? Because otherwise we'd go like this. Right? Right, Henry? So we fold our hands and close our eyes and pray. Sometimes the Bible talks about holding your hands up in the air, and that's just fine. You might see me do that up front sometimes. Or if you ever watch a video or a movie of Orthodox Jews at the Wailing Wall, do you know what they do? They move their whole bodies and they bob back and forth because they want to make sure that not only is their soul praying, but their whole body is involved. All of them, their whole person is praying. I think that's kind of neat. So what position, posture you have is not all that important. What Jesus wants to make sure we do, and do often, is pray. Because God wants to have a relationship with each and every one of us. So pray often. We're going to pray right now. So you could fold your hands and close your eyes and repeat after me. Gracious God, we do love you. Help us to pray. Help us to know you more and more each day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, you can go back to your seats. At the early service, one of our young people said, "Did you know that in 200 million years, the Earth's sun will turn into a supernova?" Time is running out, folks. 200 million years. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Persistence in prayer. This is my favorite story about prayer and persistence in prayer. Do you remember when I told you the story of Pacific Garden Mission in Chicago? Anybody remember that? It's been a number of years, but it's my favorite story about prayer. A colonel back in the 1800s, the late 1800s, 1877, I believe, a colonel and his wife, Sarah, believed that God was calling them to start a ministry for homeless people in Chicago. And they found a beer garden that had gone out of business. It was called Pacific Beer Garden. And they rented this facility, and all they had was enough money for 1 month's rent. And they believed that if this ministry was going to be successful, God would provide. So right away, they started praying, "Dear Lord, we need next month's rent." The first week went by, no rent, no money. Second week went by. They prayed all week long, no money. Third week, they were getting a little more anxious. Their prayers were a little bit more fervent, no money. The last week, no money. The last day, they decided, we need an all-night vigil. So they prayed all night long. In the morning, no money. And they made them question themselves, and what should this ministry really be about? When the colonel looks out the window, and there on the front lawn were a bunch of white spots. And he went down and he looked at them, and they were mushrooms. And he picked a half a dozen, put them in a handkerchief, walked down to the restaurant in a 5-star hotel about 5 blocks away, showed them to the chef, and the chef said, "Oh, these are very fine mushrooms. I will take as many as you have. In fact, I am going to come and harvest them." So he came that day and harvested enough mushrooms to pay the rent. Now, I always think that so much beer was spilled on that front lawn, that was fertilizer for all those mushrooms. But then, every day, the chef would come with his wheelbarrow and harvest mushrooms. And they wound up with enough money for the next 3 months' rent. And that's how Pacific Garden Mission, not Beer Garden Mission, Pacific Garden Mission got its start. Isn't that a great story about prayer and persistence in prayer and having one's prayer life aligned beautifully with God, wanting God's name to be honored, God's will to be done, a mission to help people on earth so God's kingdom could be here on earth as it is in heaven. I love that story. I'm glad you didn't remember it so I could tell it again. Primary reason for prayer, Jesus seems to be letting us know, the primary reason for prayer is for us to develop a relationship with God and cultivate that relationship with God. So we are to pray persistently, always, about everything. About relationship. Begins with the first word, Father. A few years ago, half a dozen of us went to Nashville for the Lutheran Men and Missions conference. And at that conference, one of the speakers decided we needed to have a prayer, and he called on a pastor, an associate pastor, one of the many pastors, I'm sure, that they have at Lutheran Church of Hope in West Des Moines, Iowa. That's one of those churches that's 8,000-10,000 members or maybe more. And when this pastor got up there, young guy, gets up to pray, he starts his prayer by saying, "Daddy." And then every reference to God was Daddy, rather than Father. And afterwards, we men got together, which we would often do to talk about the day and what was going on. Boy, did you hear that, Daddy? Boy, I'm just uncomfortable with that. How could he do that? Then lo and behold, you look at the Lord's Prayer. Jesus uses the word in Greek, Abba. The best we know, the best way to translate that is a word of endearment, Daddy. Maybe we could say Dad, but Daddy. You see, God, Jesus is showing us that God Almighty wants to have a relationship with us. So when you pray, say Father. No, say Daddy. It's about relationship. Secondly, pray for daily bread. Pray for anything. There's nothing so small that God does not care about it, and there is nothing so large that God cannot overcome it. The two of you together, pray for daily bread. Daily bread, of course, does not mean bread, does not mean merely food. It means everything we need for daily life, as Martin Luther would share with us. Let me share a story about Diane Stark. Diane Stark was raised in a religious home, had a very strict religious upbringing, had a very strict disciplinarian father. Diane Stark was trained to read her Bible daily, was trained to pray often. She was in church every time the doors were open with her father right there. And then, and she said her life was a very good life, a very fine life, until the entire family felt betrayed by her father, who had an affair. Her father and her mother then were divorced. She was at that age where she was just leaving home for college and a life of her own, and at that time, she stopped reading her Bible. She stopped praying. She stopped going to worship. She said, what is the sense? We had such a nice family, a nice Christian family, and we're broken up by betrayal. How could God allow this? So, Sunday mornings, she slept in, got on with her life, got married, had a couple of kids. And when her son Jason was 9 years old, he came walking in holding a Bible. He said, Mom, whose Bible is this? And she said, Jason, it's my Bible. I used to read that every day. And I said, oh, Mom, don't you read it anymore? And she says, no. And he says, why? Don't you believe in God? She said, for the first moment in years, she had looked back upon her life, the good and the bad. And she said, oh, no, I believe in God. I still believe in God. And Jason said, well, show us some of your favorite Bible passages. So she did. And she opened them up, and you could see how her favorites were often the favorites of others. All things are possible for God. All things work together for good for those who love God. And then she says, here's another one. I can do all things through him who strengthens me. And Jason said, well, can I have your Bible? I'd like to write those Bible verses down. And a few minutes later, he came back into his mother and he said, Mom, I noticed something that's the same in all your Bible verses. And Diane Stark said, what's that? And he said, you have underlined twice two words in each of those verses. All things. Diane Stark said, my heart broke open at that moment. It broke open and allowed God's grace to come in. she recognized how wrong she had been, how wrong she had been to abandon God, because God promised to be present in all things, not just good things, not just some things, but all things. And she recognized that God was there, even in her abandonment of God. For the first time in years, she prayed, "Thank you, God, for Jordan, for his finding my Bible. Thank you, God, for loving me in all things, even when I abandoned you." Diane Stark recognized and realized what daily bread was. God is there, giving us everything we need from day to day. He's there in all things. Forgiveness. Forgive us, we pray, as we are forgiving others. Forgiveness. That's a key to the Christian life. Forgiveness. That's a key to our sanity in life. Dear God, forgive me. Dear God, help me. Forgiveness. Diane Stark realized that when she looked back on her life and looked back upon the betrayal of her father and her abandoning God, recognizing in her a need for forgiveness, helped her to look upon her father's misdeeds with some mercy and some grace and forgiveness. Dear Lord, forgive us just as we are forgiving others. Finally, we have a parable. Notice, first off, parables are not always one-to-one comparisons. For instance, if we were to think that God Almighty was to be compared to this friend sleeping with his family, and you knock on his door, and we're the ones that are pleading, "Open up and give me three loaves of bread," that seems rather strange. But what the parable is about, going to a friend. Notice how it doesn't say he merely went to his neighbor. No, he went to a friend. God is our friend. Remember, Abba, our friend we go to. And we ask him for what we need. And he supplies that need. So Jesus says, pray to Abba, your daddy, and he will listen. Develop that relationship. Let him love you, forgive you, and sustain you with every need. Amen.
Please rise and join in singing as we share our tithes and offerings.
Seems like there's so much to go for, so many dreams are there.
Us together as one church. Help us all, your disciples, to ask for the things we need, confident that you will hear us, Lord, in your mercy. Call us to notice places and people you created, but we often forget, for busy places, for those working in the noon heat, in the silence of the night, and in the care of your creation. Lord, in your mercy, bring peace where strife is found. We pray for race relations in this country and those places suffering from police killings and from police officers being slain. Dallas, Baton Rouge, Kansas City, and other places. And where terror strikes, Afghanistan, Germany, Orlando. Empower leaders and organizations to find solutions through persistence and faith. Lord, in your mercy. Protecting God, sustain police officers, firefighters, EMTs, and others who attend to public safety. Uphold those who are sick. We pray especially for Meredith Adams, Lael Biela, Drew Bowman, Carolyn Callan, Pam Cole, Lyle and Lucy Dolly, Jeff Dykeman, Jeff Hemphill, Mark Henson, Alan Kamens, Chris Marquardt, and Rod Thurman. Are there any others? You are the God of our salvation. You have enabled us to share in the inheritance of the saints in light. Hold in your eternal light those who have died especially Benita Stamper. Lord, in your mercy, seek after us wherever we are found in these summer months. Grant safety to those who travel, Sabbath rest to those who vacation, and perseverance to those who have no leisure time. Lord, in your mercy. Be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Holy, mighty, and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love, you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we await his coming in glory. Pour out upon us the spirit of your love, O Lord, and unite the wills of all who share this heavenly food, the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. All is ready. Our Lord invites us. Please come. You may be seated.
This is a body, and this is a blood, broken and poured out for all of us. And in this communion, we share in his love. This is a body, and this is a blood. I will remember everything, Lord, that you've done for me. I won't take for granted the sacrifice that set me free. Well, I hunger and thirst for your love. Come fill me today. This is a body. This cross is above, broken and poured out for all of us. And in this communion, we share in His love. This is a body, and this is a blood. I will remember everything, Lord, that You've done for me. I won't take for granted the sacrifice that set me free. We hunger and thirst for Your love and Your righteousness. We long for Your presence, Lord. Be with us again. This is a body. This is a blood. Broken and poured out for all of us. Communion, we share His love. This is a body. This is a blood. This is a body. This is a blood. Broken and poured out for all of us. In this communion, we share in His love. This is a body. This is a love. This is a body. This is a blood. This is a body. This is a blood.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, through the gifts of His body and blood, strengthen, keep, and unite us, now and forever. Amen. Gracious God, in this meal You draw us close to Your heart. We thank You for making us Your friends. We thank You that we belong to You. Filled with Your love, help us to leave this place empowered to share Your love and Your mercy and Your grace with all we meet. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And now receive this benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen.
Lord.
Thanks be to God.
There is a peace, there is a love.